We begin with the latest on the conflict in the Middle East, where Israel is preparing for a ground offensive into Gaza as the country's war with Hamas intensifies. Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo has the latest from Tel Aviv.
New vision from inside Gaza revealing widespread destruction and just some of the human suffering. The dead are being buried. Here, 18 members of the same family are laid to rest as the injured keep arriving at Gaza's hospitals, which are now on the cusp of complete collapse.
The machines are no longer working because the water pressure now has dropped to the point where they can't function.
It had been hoped humanitarian aid would get in through the Rafah crossing at Egypt, but a ceasefire and border opening didn't eventuate. Hundreds of Palestinian dual nationals and foreign nationals had swarmed to the gates in search of safety, but despite diplomatic efforts, the crossing remains closed.
The situation is threatening my life and everybody's life. You can't be safe here.
Israel today also under attack in Tel Aviv and Jerusalem. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has met with his security cabinet as preparations for the ground offensive continue. Another complicating factor, confirmation from Israel that 199 hostages are in Gaza, that number higher than first feared.
This will be a long war. The price will be high, but we are going to win.
Protection of the force is going to be very important for Israel. They don't want to lose casualties on their side.
Soldiers are undergoing further training as towns close to the border lock down, with Israel's ground invasion expected at any moment.
More and more roadblocks are being set up across southern Israel. Some cars and trucks are being stopped and searched. We've also seen an increase in military equipment on the move.
This is a nation ready for battle and ready for retribution after the horror unleashed by Hamas. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, Tel Aviv.
Deputy Prime Minister Richard Marles has confirmed there are no more repatriation flights planned to leave Israel. Overnight, two extra flights left Tel Aviv and have now landed in Dubai. Nearly 200 people were on board. About half were Australian citizens. It brings the total number of Aussies helped by the government to leave the conflict to more than 1,400.
We don't have any more flights planned. We believe that these flights do meet the immediate demand on the part of Australians to leave Israel. That said, we are keeping a couple of Air Force planes in the region as a contingency over the coming days.
It's as the government reveals the number of known Australian citizens in Gaza has grown to 45. The Deputy Prime Minister says they should move south while the government works towards bringing them home.